Nongcebo Vukile McKenzie, and this is the podcast, Sawubona. Every fortnight, a guest joins us for a conversation or to share a story. It's a pleasure to share these with you and to have you with us. Welcome, ngiyakwamukela, to another episode of Nongcebo McKenzie, the podcast. We're continuing in our series of conversations about property. We are joined again by Malusi Mthuli, property valuer. He's currently the properties executive at Ithala Development Finance Corporation, and he's the former president of the South African Institute of Property Valuers. We looked at what is it really that drives value in property, when you look at what is it that really will influence the market price of a property. That's a previous discussion that we had with him in the podcast. But today, what we're really looking at, Malusi, I haven't even welcomed you. Welcome to the
Thank
podcast.
Thank you. Good to be here, always.
What we're looking at today is we're seeing an urban-rural migration.
Mm.
Right. And when we spoke about what drives market price and what drives value of property, you spoke of things of access to amenities, access to major transport routes and all those things. And when we look at the urban to rural migration across demographics,
mm-hmm.
because, you know, there are these lifestyle estates that we are seeing Absolutely. Now, country living mm-hmm. close to, you know, but thina sibuyele emakhaya sambe siyokwakha imizi yethu enako konke esingakuthola la emadolobheni, so senza sure ukuthi siyakuthola nakho lokho emakhaya. What's driving that from a property point of view?
Oh, thank you, Nongcebo. It's actually a very broad question, because as usual with property, there's a lot of aspects that actually influence behavior, influence how the markets behave. And in this case, you see a lot of migration, I think, happening from the urban setting, mm-hmm. moving to the rural setting.
Mm-hmm.
Motivation for that is twofold. You mentioned one, which is lifestyle.
Mm-hmm.
The second one is actually the business opportunities in the untapped market in the rural setting. So you do find some level of migration of people going there to set up opportunities to generate revenue, whether you're farming cattle, whether you're farming, crops to sell, or whether you actually want to set up a commercial enterprise in the form of a shopping center, or to provide a service that doesn't exist there. So those opportunities obviously exist there. Yes, there are few and far in between, but they do exist as well. And it's an untapped market. And when there's a limited supply of a particular service, and specifically in this case, property, you know, the property prospectors will obviously see that gap and try and attack it to obviously generate revenue. But predominantly, the migration is actually informed by lifestyle. You've mentioned that it's across demographics. You do find established estates
mm-hmm.
where there is that lifestyle motivation to go and live in an area where you can keep horses, equestrian setting, for instance, Summerfeld, when you just next door to Kloof, people want to live there because of the lifestyle and the expansive nature of the land and where they can actually keep horses. There's a number of other estates that are actually driven by that type of lifestyle. People, you know, choose to actually live in a hectare, you know, somewhere in Palito. People want to actually farm certain crops and actually, you know, look to retire in that particular mm-hmm. setting. And by and large as well, you see quite a lot of people moving to the rural areas, either to get close to their, areas of ancestry, or where they can actually, do some small-scale farming, but also other aspects like, kuthi ngifuna ungcwajwa mina la, ngifuna ukuhlala endaweni yobukhosi, in a communal, inkaba yami ila, yabo siyasina umsinzi wokuyimilela from this particular area. So those are the kind of aspects that actually drive people to move away. And sometimes, people have lived in the cities for decades on end, and they just want change,
mm-hmm.
and they want a bit of tranquility, a bit of quietness. They want to lead a very simple life.
Mm-hmm.
You want to actually live that on a permanent basis,
mm-hmm.
Where you actually appreciate, the little that you have, as opposed to actually living in the cities full of abundance.
So when we consider this from the estate's point of view, where there's a particular community that it serves, the equestrian community. Some of these estates up in the north, I love the marketing brochures. Children will be holding little chickens under their arms and they're running around with little chickens and all of that. And I would gather from that it's structured in a certain way, it's priced in a certain way, and it's marketed in a certain way, and it serves that kind of demographic. But for the urban migration, or rather the urban-rural migration to endaweni zasemakhaya, it's not marketed, number one.
Yeah.
It's usually ukuthi umuntu ngiphiwa indawo noma ngithola indawo noma kunendawo. I mean, there are people like in certain professions uthothe mhlawumbe udokotela ngasendaweni yasemakhaya, uthothe mhlawumbe kukhona umuntu obenendawo wabasiza, hawu babonga, bambonga ngokuthi nje bamdabulela indawo bathi hayi kwakuyindawo yakithi le, sesizokupha le ndawo, mhlawumbe uthothe uphiwa indawo kanjalo. Omunye athi ufuna ukubuyela ekhaya, you know, mina ngowakwaMadlala and ngikhulele khona, ngeze eThekwini ngokuzozama amathuba omsebenzi, but mina ngowakwaMadlala. So for me, going back home is always been important. It was always going to be something that would happen at some point in some way, shape, form or kind. So those are the kinds of things that we see driving ukuthi abantu babuyele endaweni zasemakhaya. But it's not done in the same way and the motivations are not the same. But we are recreating leli dolobha esilibalekelayo. Silifike silikhande lapha.
Yeah.
Wakhe dolobha. Wakhe dolobha. Ubiya ngoba ufuna ukuhlala endaweni enhle
kunjalo
nephakethe liyakuvumela ukuthi uyakhe lendlu yakho enhle, ufake oplumbing bakho, ufake ogesi, kube kuhle, kube nje yakhona la emakhaya iphile impilo. But now here's the thing, when you do that endaweni that has got all the drivers of value that we discussed, you can sort of like predict to a certain degree the outcome of that. Now uzibuzi, hey, amandla ami amangaka. Lezi ingane zizovuma yini ukuhlala la uma sengugugile amandla esephelile. What kinds of things do we need to consider? Firstly, from a cost to value point of view, and also from all the other aspects that you need to consider. Uma ukuthi uyasuka ke manje uthi ngiyokwakha emakhaya.
That question is very close to heart. We see a lot of urbanization where people move from rural to urban areas. But then rural semigration is an area with property that is not so well studied. Being involved in this property industry, I can tell you without any hesitation that this is a multi-billion rand business and industry. And yet it's not formalized. And it is actually one of the biggest opportunities and areas that are untapped, because I think, you know, there's a lot of people that want to move back to emakhaya, ngiyokwakha emakhaya. Because if you actually talk to just about a random person, they'll tell you ukuthi mina ngisuka endaweni ewukuthi. And deep down, when you probe into that conversation, you find ukuthi they'd want to actually set up base from back emakhaya, ngiyohlala la ngisuka khona. So it's a huge industry. Unfortunately, due to ukuthi it's not formalized, you find ukuthi information is not in abundance. You find ukuthi there's no one that is actually tracking ama transactions or potential transactions enzakalayo endaweni zasemakhaya ukudayiselana izindlu. Akekho umuntu otrackayo ukuthi ama sites adayisa ngamalini. Uyaya endaweni enkosi uze kuthiwa induna idayisa u-40 by 40. Isite yakhona ngu-40,000, abanye 20,000. So you don't really get to ama details or to establish ukuthi how is this market trending, and why, what is actually driving this market, who is actually buying, because there are wonke ama aspects that you actually consider in the valuation of urban property. Who are the buyers? What is the age profile? What is the gender? What is the demographic profile? And what is their economic status in terms of earning range? There's this thing called LSM and all of those things. We don't have those details, but we do know that a lot of people are cashing out on their pension to build a makai. A lot of people are actually releasing equity from their urban homes to build a makai. A lot of people are taking some cash flows that actually, you know, end up on their lap by wakha makai. But we're not measuring the size of that industry so as to formalize it and actually make sure that there are mechanisms that actually encourage that market, because it's an important market.
So now, the inability to track it, is it not driven by the fact that that whole market and I say this as a broad statement, is not credit driven. And where things are not credit driven, it's really hard. It becomes harder to track because it's cash. You will buy immaterial yogurt work, and you've got to have the cash to do that because I'm not a home loan. So we're not tracking. You can't track defaulters. You can't track because whereas you can track abantu abanama home loan, you can be precise. In this quarter, in Q1 or Q2, X number of people were not able, because of the economic downturn, to pay their home loans. And these are the number of people that have had to sell because they can't afford, etc. Is that not one of the conditions?
I'm a firm believer that any market, as long as there's cash and as long as there's benefits, mm-hmm. and as long as there's exchange of wealth, mm-hmm. can be formalized. Mm-hmm. I'll make an example. There is this market that is often referred to as the unseen market by the banking sector. And this is the market where it trades in Gokeshi, a maspaza shop, nan. They see that market and they see how big it is, mm-hmm. and they want to tap into it. So what do? They create rails so as to encroach and be able to participate and also make money out of it. So bazoya kuma spaza shop amanya ono abantu ama foreign nationals amanya ono abantu abakhona la South Africa. They come in and say, no, we'll give you a machine ezokusiza ukuthi utransact even without cash. We'll actually send a van around to actually collect your cash and bank it, because by doing that, then they actually tap into that space. They come up with mechanisms like my vouchers, because it's a huge market. Likewise, a industry and this huge market, mm-hmm. of a band to buy a wakemakai, and it's big monies, has to be formalized. There has to be a concerted effort to try and actually track the market activity, to get the data on who's participating, mm-hmm. and also find mechanisms. So kuthi sikwazi ukuthi zibafane yabona umuntu umuntu uzoqala akhe mthambi uno 500,000 rand ephaketheni ungapheli umuzi uthola ukuthi ushoda ngo 250,000. Why lo muntu engalitholi usizo? And bese ufakile lo 500,000 rand, why engakwazi ukuthi uma ngabe efuna usizo lokuthi nayi value ngizobekisa ngayo nginikezene imali encane ukuthi ngikwazi ukuthi ngiqedele, yindaba engalitholi usizo. So there's a massive, I think, missed opportunity by the market. Currently, the funders or the credit that people abakha emakhaya, that you know, that is available, ile abayithola ema hardware. I'm more than willing to ask you, no, so nigeza, go by, you end the salary, we're going to give you credits, got 300,000, humble, galu work. But a lot 300,000, those interest at all, which including raise man. And yet, in the urban setting, if you're building property, it's usually the cheapest form of credit that you can get because it's secured. So that's the missed opportunity. So, to look at these zonkis into lays as zenza, which the market will cool. But at the moment, go by data. I can assure you, if ngabe you can come up with a data bank that you can share with the market, could say this is a 10 billion rand market, mm-hmm. completely unbanked, completely without credit market, come up with a plan. If a company could come up with a plan to fund ama taxi operators, that was the market that was previously not banked. Amatekis used to be bought in cash. You'd have a few about connectivity credits at bank. But someone made an effort to collect the data, mm-hmm. understand the market, mm-hmm. understand the milestones that actually need to be achieved before go to con go to realize the investment. And then they came up with a funding package. Nakhona la, we need to understand indawo zasemakhaya, ubukhosi, indawo abantu banikezwa kanjani, and ku safe kanjani ukuhlala endaweni uinvestile kuyona, so that leyo data can then be processed and then kube na some opportunity to formalize it.
So, and I'm going to ask this question, it sounds counterintuitive.
Yes.
But does it need to be formalized? What about it is not working, if there's anything that's not working? What is the benefit of formalizing it? How would that help me as a consumer? How would it help me as umuntu wakwamadlala?
Yeah, so there's many levels are important that can be achieved easier if ngabe that market is formalized. Mm-hmm. Ne? So the first one is kunomuntu osebenza eGoli obuya elentweni emaqonqo ufuna ukuthi ayokwakhe ekhaya kodwa manje akanama means two akanayo capacity ukuthi akhe so you can't set up a formal building project where you can actually have a contract when you know it's funded and there is a funder that is looking after your interest to make sure that property gets completed, becomes a missed opportunity. It's a massive missed opportunity
for the consumer. Because they can't build now.
For the consumer and for the local business, because kumbula pela bo wakala kono muntu omaki kono muntu wakama aluminium kono muntu enzi tiling kono muntu enzi na ngithi yabona ukuthi it's you know there's a whole department in government that talks about rural development. This is rural development. So we can't be just looking at rural development on the basis of ukuthi abantu banama farm abantu
kunama
projects bakhelwa ama crash bakhelwa iikole. No, that is part of it. But there's also the economy that needs to be developed. And this, for me, is one of the biggest opportunities that can be exploited to open up this market and create more opportunities in these rural settings. Akungenzeki isimo enongcebo la ukuthi umuntu kufanele ukuthi asebenze 40 years. Athe seretire, sekuhlungu ngisho iqolo, akusahambeki. Yila ekhona yogijima esayithini eyokwakha umuzi wokugugela. Athi mese seretire, mhlawumbe ahlale kwalowo 5 years uthole ukuthi seshayelwe isikhathi. Asizame ukuthi silihambise, you know, try and bring a clock closer to people establishing themselves in these rural settings. Sakhe ama mechanisms okuthi ngoba uyazi ukuthi ufuna ukuthi ugcine uyo retire endaweni ukuthi ufuna uyo retire eMbumbulu. So sizokwenza njani ukuthi umuzi wakho usheshe uvushwe. Even usaneminyaka e-20 yokusebenza ngithi ungalindi ukuthi uzobe na 60 kuyima uzohlushwa bakhe ngoba nabo bakhe bahlupha ngithi. So kodwa the moment you formalize it nalapho ukhona ukuthi ukwazi ukutracka even nabakhe abahluphayo ukwazi ukuthi ubheke izinto ezifana nequality material wazi ukuthi okay yini esebenza nama details nje endawo yabo khona umhlaba ongathi wakhe khona indlu yakhe igcine imuva ugcina usuphelelwa investment yakho ukwazi zonke lawo ama details ube khona umhlaba o right ekufanele kwakhe kwona. So the moment it's formalized then there's an injection of imali or what they refer to as capital and zonke lezo zinto and those boxes which are essential end up being ticked.
And I would then gather from what you're saying that ticking all those boxes then allows for a situation where there can be a value assignment to that asset because it's now tracked. It's done in a manner where there are what is the proper word? There are certain fulfillments, if I can put it that way, that one needs to meet. Because, for example, uma kuwukuthi mhlawumbe ufuna ukuthenga umuzi fana uthathe home loan, fana bekhona i-difficulty ezahlukahlukene eziphumayo lapho eziqinisekisayo ukuthi, I mean, they need to check for wood borer, they need to check that the electricity connection is safe, they need to check all of those things before ugrantele leyo home loan iphasiswe, assesswe, ithiweni indlu. And I suppose then it would then drive those, because as you're saying, ma wakhe endaweni engekho right. Uzothola ukuthi umhlaba lokhu zika and then indlu igcina siba isichachamba and then sinemkenke and then you've got a bit of a problem. And then also what then do you do in that situation? Where do you go ukuthi umuzi wakho ulungise? Sekufanele ukhiphe kuphi manje ephaketheni again. So I suppose it would mitigate those.
Absolutely. And angithi nginama protections abantu abakhelwa endaweni zasemadolobheni abanawo. For instance, uma usebenzisa i-boulder ke kuthiwa sebenzisa i-boulder registered with the NHBRC, National Home Builders Regulatory Council Authority. So uma ngabe usebenzisa leyo boulder and wakhela umuzi wakho uphele and if within 5 years umuzi wakho uqale ube nama structural failures ube ney'nkinga uqale uvuze, you can always go to NHBRC, which was nango makhwanga khena urejistile nani ukhokhile i-land subscription yenani nakho and umuzi awakhile nango usungulethisele iy'nkinga. I-NHBRC has a commitment ukuthi ukwazi ukuthi bakukhiphele imali ukuthi ukwazi ukulungisa lezo zinto. So emakhaya asinawo lama protections. So yilezo zinto esingakwazi ukuthi uma ngabe you formalize that part of the market ukuthi sikwazi ukuthi silethe ama-benefits afana njengalawo. Uke wathinta elinye ipoint ekuqaleni about cost and value. Currently, due to ukuthi information is not in abundance. For instance, if one's evaluation endaweni yasedolobheni. You get information through deeds registry, you get information about ama transactions kunama estate agents. Asinama estate agents emakhaya. If they are there ba benza lento ukuthi nje bazofika bazodesa lo muzi bahamba. You don't see abantu who are actively participating to drive the trading of properties esemakhaya. So isikhathi esiningi uma ngabe ubheka I value ne cost emakhaya, isikhathi esiningi uma ngabe kukhona ama properties adayisayo ahlale ephushwa yini ukuthi abiza malini ukwakha, which is not necessarily the basis of a value, because a value might be related or to a cost. Kodwa it doesn't mean ukuthi if it cost you R1 million to build a house, then the value is R1 million. Kodwa ngenxa absence of data and the formalization of that market, you'd find ukuthi that cost aspect will come into play uma ngabe uthi uthenga emakhaya. Edolobheni, for instance, the cost could be less than the value, or it could be vice versa. But emakhaya, you actually don't have any other benchmark but the cost. Uma ngabe ubona isitezi, uzohlala ucabanga ukuthi ayikwakha lesa sitezi vele ngangikhost R1.5 million, angimkhokheli R1.5 million. Kodwa akusiyo indlela imakethi ekufane ngabe isebenza kanjalo. Kufanele kube ukuthi kunama-transactions arekhodwayo, and then kuhambe kubonakale ukuthi hayi noma ngicabe ama-properties, uma ungabe uyothenga imbumbulu kahlahla dayisa la ko-R1 million, uma uyothenga lapha emgababa, maybe you can get away with R750 yabo, izinto ey'fana njengalezo. And then you establish ukuthi imakethi ihamba kanje and iyona price, and then you give abantu opportunities aba investor futhi nakhona ukuthi bakwazi ukuthi uma be investor benze iprofit, bangakhokhela kuphela imali abasuke bespendile ngodaka ne-18.
So now I'm curious, are people emakhaya wanting to sell though? Are we building and moving out of cities because sengifuna ukuthi ngithole ikhaya lami lapho engizoretire khona, or ngikhumbule ekhaya but angikwazi ukubuyela ekhaya elikhulu? Are people really looking to sell? Noma ngifuna ukwakha umuzi wey'ngane zami, ngeke uyithembe into yasemadolobheni, ngifuna nje iy'ngane zami zibe nento ezizoyikhomba amandla ma. Are we really looking to sell at some point?
I'd say the majority of the market is not building to sell. Kodwa nakhona, just like in the urban setting, if ngabe uthenga i-property usuke ungayithengi ngoba unenhloso yokuthi uyayidayisa, especially uma kuyi-property ozoyithenga ukuthi uyohlala kuyona. So it's another thing ukuthi unongcebo uhlala kule flat and then uthenga i-flat else next door, noma uthenge in the next block. We invest lapho, siya trade. So kodwa kunama circumstances, even noma kuthiwa uthenge lento ebizwa nge-primary residence, othola ukuthi ngokuhamba kwesikhathi ufuna ukuthi uthi uzo-upgrade noma uya-downscaler, and ufuna ukuthi udayise or ufuna ukushintsha la uhleli khona ngesimo sokushintsha kwezinto zomsebenzi. So the reason why kodwa ingekho that market yokuthi kudayiswe ima-properties asemakhaya, it's because akukho easy. We do not have the rails to do so. Now, here's one thing that you need to understand though about the demand. Whenever there's demand, it means goods as a supplier, there's an opportunity. So now, between you and I, we can definitely agree without any shadow of doubt that there is demand for properties in down the Semakai. So you ask yourself, who is the supplier? I do not know a single developer eyakha imizi emakhaya idayisela abantu ama-packages esephelele. But why is that the case? Because there is a market. Khona umuntu onayo imali ofuna ukuthi uthi hey, le nto yokwakha mina, the reason why ngingakhile, ingakho abantu abaningi bethenga ama-site, uthole ukuthi akakhiwe ngobani? Isikhathi abanaso. So kuthi bayakwakha noma sikakafiki leso. Kodwa if ngabe kungakhona umuntu ongaba proactive athi endaweni ewukuthi lapha e-unpacks ngase-Maritzburg, hey, bayethanda abantu leya ndawo, ku-12 minutes kusuka khona ufike e-Maritzburg, ake ngithenge ama-site, ngihambe ngenkosini, ngifike ngibuye nje mhlawumbe imali ukuthi ngithole ama-site awu-8. Mese ngiwatholile ama-site awu-8, ngizowakha indlu eyodwa. Mese ngiyakhini ngiyiqede ngale ndlela engiqeda ngayo. Mese ngiyidayisa, ngisho ukuthi wozani nizothenga. Nanka amanye ama-site awu-8. Uma uyifuna, shaya i-deposit ukuthi ngizokwakhela kule site le ukuthi. Izothi singaphela sengisukhokha imali ezenene. Izophuma inje. Mhlawumbe kuwuyena-ke umuntu oyishintshayo. Akekho umuntu okwenzayo lokho. Kodwa part of ukuthi kungenzeki lokho, it's because nayo i-funding ayikho. Angithi it goes back to le question yokuqala ukuthi is it necessary ukuthi kube ne-funding? Mina ngokwami ngithi yes, because we know ukuthi demand is there. Kodwa the speed with which indawo zasemakhaya is developing is slow because ayikho funding. So let us create the rails, let us create the data that actually allows for this market to be formalized, so that sizokwazi ukuthi ifundeke. Uma isifundeka uzobona abantu ukuthi bazobe begijima kanjani beyokwakha emakhaya bazokwakha a lot sooner than isikhathi sokuretire.
But it is in terms of the practicality, it's not just limited to funding.
Absolutely.
It's not
security
just
of tenure, yeah. Ownership, zonke lezo zinto. They become important, and that is where amakhosi also have a role to play. Kwesi isikhathi uzohamba nginokuhlala namakhansela asebukhosini, nginokuhlala even namakhosi, uthole ukuthi bokukhuluma lezi ezinye izinto kwesi isikhathi mase usuzifaka isilungu kakhulu, kuvele kube ngathi hayi usuzokhuthuza abantu. Usuzokhuthuza abantu. Mina abantu besizwe ba-right nje, ngibabeka hamba ohlala laphaya, wakhe laphaya, ubekile lelokhu esinebhodlela, wabikwa enkosini, kwahlangana umphakathi, kwadliwa inyama, hhayi usuyilunga lomphakathi. Kodwa there are many opportunities. Engicabanga ukuthi with the correct guidance, nakhona sivume baningi abantu abafikayo ngomqondo wokuthi sizebukhosini abanalo mhlawumbe lo lwazi sizobagenda kanje 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 siphele endaweni sesihamba nemali kuyenzeka kakhulu. So nakhona ungangawugxeka ubukhosi kwesinye isikhathi ungafuni ukuthi kulalele kakhulu lezi zinto lezi eziyazithatha ukuthi zafika nondlebe esikhanyelanga. So ngale ndlela, I think there's a big opportunity where we can look at even a security of tenure, where we can formalize a structure. It doesn't even have to be a title deed. Kodwa where there's a structure, umuntu angakwazi ukuthi athole comfort ukuthi, no, I actually have this piece of paper. It is legally binding. Ngiyazi ukuthi le site le ibiza mina. Ayikho futhi enye indlela yokuthi ngasukiye komunye umuntu. There's ways to register my real rights. There's ways to even register my leaseholds. There's ways where umuntu, of course, uma ngabe ubona indawo, ukwazi ukuthi ubuyisike ubu-subdivide ngendlela ibhalwe phansi ekutheni ukuthi uma sazi ukuthi uThabethe unikezwe lowa side number one, unezwe side number one. Ayikho futhi ukuthi i-land idathe ukuthi eyakhe lo side number one. So yilezo zinto ey'ncane kodwa which actually have the biggest impact. Nakhona inkonya ama-trust akufanele ukuthi salele kude kwizinto ezingabe zenziwe ebukhosini ekutheni ukuthi i-market lay-formalize.
Thank you very much, Malusi, for that insight and that information, because these are very, very important conversations that need to be had. Because when we're talking urban-rural migration, we are going back having come from cities, our parents having worked hard for us to get an education, to be informed, to be empowered. But we also still want to have that good quality of life. We want to have the services. We want to have all of that. And there are certain things that are the backbones of making sure that that happens in a harmonious way when we go back to endaweni zasemakhaya. So these are very important conversations. And we thank you for joining us on the podcast to share this information with us. Thank you.
Thank you. Always good to be here.
Thank you for joining us on this episode of the podcast. Remember, you can like the episode and share the podcast link, as well as listen to more episodes on the channel. Subscribe to the channel for more. Siyabonga. Thank you for listening.